All right, guys, so I'm here with George Lehman. If you guys don't know him, George Lehman, I'm going to let him introduce himself in a second, but just to brag really quickly for him. George, 23 years old, my age, pulled over 909 pounds recently, setting the U.S. record.
Yeah, the raw one.
Raw record. At 22, he had pulled 906 with straps as a tribute to his father. That's on his channel as well.
Yep.
And then even before that, as like a teenager, you were pulling crazy amounts of weights.
Yeah. When I was 17, I could deadlift 700 for four. And the thing I did wrong was I bulked up too fast.
Did you?
Yeah, I bulked up too fast and it ruins your leverages. So
that's like, crazy.
You'd think you just keep getting heavier and shit, you keep getting stronger. No, it's about as fat as I can be and still be like good right. at deadlifting. Then you start seeing people get like their stomach out to here and shit, and they're over here in front of the bar. You know what
I mean? Yeah.
So you'll see like some of the strongest people can squat like 1,000 pounds. They deadlift like 600.
Yep.
It's just a completely leverage oriented thing.
So the first time you ever deadlifted, how old were you and how much were you able to pull?
14 years old. I've been doing back and like, well, you know, pull downs and leg press and shit. And I could do 295, I did like 185, 205, 215. It just kept going up because more weight kept going up. And I ended up like sumo deadlift hitching 295.
First time ever at 14.
First time ever, yeah. Some right around there. And then my brother though, who was 2 years older, pulled like 365. And the very next workout he did 405. So it's definitely in my cards to deadlift a lot, I would say.
What kind of bar is that?
Texas deadlift bar.
Texas deadlift. So I have the Oki bar. What's the difference between the Texas and the Oki?
This one's slightly longer, probably like 2 or 3 inches longer, something like that. A little bit thinner, and it bends a little bit better.
So a little bit more whip?
A little bit more whip.
Cool. How old were you the first time you ever pulled 800 pounds?
I mean, 20. I think I was 20 years old, yeah. I just got done dieting, and on the diet, I'd been getting stronger because my leverages came back. I bumped up to like 385 at 18.
What's your reasoning for the bumpers?
Gets the weights a little bit further out to the side. Not just that though, but like the plates won't wobble back and forth if these are thicker. See how this thing doesn't wobble?
Right, right.
It's just they're perfect. So I'll use like that in the bumpers. And I started dieting from 18 to 20, give it 19 to 20. And I got down to like 260 and I was stronger than ever on deadlifts. I had like 695 for 10. And by the time I got down to 235, I was like weaker again. I'm getting lean and shit, can't lift as much. And I bulked back up. By the time I was like 280 or 290, I went like right from like having pulled 695 for 10 as a max to like 835 for a triple. Like within like 6 weeks, it was just like, just blew right the fuck up.
That's amazing. You've had a lot of PRs posted on YouTube on your channel and stuff. I remember you pulled 800. What was your previous 800 max reps before? What do you listen to?
The first song that came on, David Guetta or some shit, Not Down With The Sickness.
Down With The Sickness? They used to be my song before every wrestling match. So you're warming up with 335 right now.
Warming up.
That is insane.
Yeah, dude, normally I start at like 3 plates.
That is insane.
You know, man, last time I was going for max reps with over 800 pounds was 815. And what was the test, the 6th rep or the 7th rep? I tore the shit out of my inner thigh on like the 5th rep or something like that. So that's by far the best I've done.
Today you pulled 800 for 8 reps.
Yeah, technically it went up on the 8th rep.
I'm speechless. Anyway, that's crazy. So when you're going to approach a deadlift, you get really intense. A lot of people who have watched you for years, I've watched you for years. In some videos, like, you're full on crying before it. You can even see it today, you're pacing, you're real intense. What goes through your mind? What do you put your mind through when you're getting ready for a deadlift? What do you feel?
I think of the same shit every single time. I always think of my little brother. I lost my little brother like 12 years ago or something like that. And I always think, I've always thought of it since I began training about 10 years ago. May 9th, it'll be 10 years, sort of my 14th birthday. I would always think of him and sort of make what I was doing insignificant. You know what I mean? Because if you go, okay, I'm going for 405 for 8, but if I get 10, I can get that person back. You're not gonna be like, well, that's impossible for me. You just get it. What's your max deadlift, roughly?
Around mid 500s, I've been testing.
Okay, let's say it's like 550. If someone said, you get 585 to save her life.
No, yeah.
Oh, you're not even gonna be like, I don't think I can. You're just gonna be like, let's do it. I can do that shit.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I always try and put myself in that state of mind of what would I do to get him back kind of thing. And it's always worked really damn well for me because I always set my standards a little bit higher than what I think I can do because of that, and it always ends up playing out to about that. I think I even told you I wanted 700 or 800 for 7 or 8.
Yeah.
That's what I was shooting for. So how the fuck do I know I can do that? I don't know. I haven't been doing sets of eight. I haven't repped with 800 pounds in a year or some shit, probably. So it's just kind of like whatever you think you can do, you can kind of do, as long as you're in the right state of mind.
I want to say it's impressive that you can even get it so real in your head that you can actually exercise it. Because a lot of people can say that, all right, well, to save my girlfriend's life, I got to get this much weight. But then kind of in the back of their mind, they don't fully believe it. They're like, well, you know, but at the end of the day, it's just the devil. She's not really going to die. Like in the back of their mind, that comes in. You make it really real.
Fortunately for me, or unfortunately, I've already lost the person. You see what I'm saying? So that's always there. You always have that shitty feeling. I've been doing it for so long, for so many years, I can pretty much bring it back whenever. Like, I don't even, I have a picture of my little brother, but I don't, like, look at it and shit.
Right.
I can't even really talk to her about it because it just, it puts me in that mood.
Of course.
I've used it for so long. It's kind of like you listen to the same song every time you train. As soon as you hear that song, you get amped.
Right, right.
Well, when I think of that, it puts me in a mood where I can move shit, more or less.
That's amazing. For those who don't know, you recently set an American record, which means you deadlift, it was just over 909 pounds, right? 909.4?
Mm-hmm.
909.4 pounds, and you did it legally, in a meet, raw grip and everything. So that's crazy. So it is on paper that you can legit, legally and completely raw, actually with a hook grip, pull 909. Yet, in all of your training videos, you always wear straps. So how do you get your grip strength to actually match up to a 909 if you always train in straps?
Mostly, it's purely technique with hook grip. I'm fortunate enough to kind of like get my adrenaline high enough that I don't feel a whole lot of pain. Mm-hmm. Like this shit on my shins, all that kind of stuff, I don't feel it. So with hook grip, by the time the weights are heavy, I don't feel shit. I just lock my hands into place. And it does take some mental cues, like you always have to really focus on squeezing your fingers and stuff like that. But if you're doing hook grip properly, you're not gonna really lose your grip unless it's like way out of reach for you. Like, okay, you can deadlift 405, you can only hold on to 405 with a mixed grip. You're not gonna be able to hold on to 900 with hook grip.
Right.
But you sure as shit might have 450, 500, maybe even like 550 or 600, if you're doing it right. I do a lot of barehanded stuff. I do a lot of barehanded like rows and shrugs,
okay.
Double overhand like static holds and shit like that. But in general, it's practicing hook grip.
Gotcha.
I tried to get my over-under stronger for years, and that's not an issue of grip strength so much as an issue of skin strength. Because once the weights are heavy enough, they just tear all the calluses off your...
What does it feel like to hold not only 800 pounds, but then hold it 8 times in a row? Like, what is going through your head? What do you feel in your body physically?
I used to be a really big fan, and everyone's going to say the same shit. I used to be a really big fan of Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah.
Really big fan. For years of my life, before I started training, I would draw them. Every day, I'd draw their bodybuilders. I would draw bodybuilders being really fucking swole and shit and fighting. And what they do is they get stronger when they're angry.
Buffalo.
You know what I mean? That's the closest thing I can equate it to. It's kind of going like beast mode. It's kind of going like Super Saiyan, if you will. It's a very addictive feeling to do shit like that. To exert that kind of like raw power and stuff like that and feel your adrenaline go that high. How does it feel? For a few seconds, it's kind of like skydiving, but sort of like you jumped up in the air first instead of went out of a plane. That's the best way to describe it. It's my favorite feeling in the world. It's just very fucking dangerous, and that's what adds to it. It's so fucking like dangerous to do that kind of shit because every time can be your last. So it's kind of like bungee jumping or kind of like skydiving.
Yeah, exactly.
Like,
I mean, at 800 pounds, that's not like you going for a 600 pound deadlift. That's like anything could snap across at 800 pounds.
Your muscles get left.
Okay.
Okay.
George Lehman, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna put his YouTube channel, it's in the info box below. He has a lot of videos out already, and he was telling me he's excited about got a new camera. You're gonna actually put real quality and effort into your channel now, right?
Oh yeah.
He's gonna go full YouTuber on us, and that's a almost 1,000 pound deadlifter going full YouTuber. So I'm gonna put your channel in the box below. You take on clients, so you have an email or a website. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna put that in the info box below too.
Badass.
And stay tuned and watch George as he goes for his 1,000-pound deadlift. I'm not gonna throw any dates or anything like that, but that's the next step, the next 1,000-pound deadlifter. One day you might see George hitting the all-time world record with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Giants Live, let me come on Giants Live. I wanna go deadlift with you guys.
Man, thanks for letting me watch that, George. That was amazing. That was amazing.
Dude.